Hi, Jim Selbach. Today I want to talk about cases where immediate action is necessary. And that would be wages being garnished, bank account frozen, car repossessed, something like that. Now, the majority of our cases that we get in our firm referred by our referring bankruptcy firms are, you know, bills, invoices, sometimes phone calls. That's the majority. And we have 15 law firms now that are part of our network, our growing network, and we have a lot of cases. So there's a line of cases that come in. And if it's one of those cases that it's a letter, et cetera, it kind of gets in line. We're very good about getting right to things. But if something comes in that needs immediate attention, that goes to the front of the line. So we talked about income executions, bank restraints, that kind of thing. One of the misconceptions, I think, with some of our referring attorneys is, okay, well, we'll send him the, you know, the one letter or the bills, et cetera, but when something's really gotta happen, we're gonna take care of that. That's a mistake, okay? And we have developed a system here that's extremely effective. So, and we've talked about this in other videos, it's very different than the traditional approach. So let's use the example of a garnishment. Okay, so there's a garnishee on your client's wages before the bankruptcy is filed. You know, a month later, he or she comes in your office and says, "What's going on? They're still taking money out of my pay." So your boss will tell you, "Get that stopped. You got to call the sheriff. You got to call the marshal. You have to find out who's actually garnishing. You have to try to get through to the attorney for the creditor." And if it's one of those, you know, something in Slamowitz and Rothman and Rothschild, whatever it is down in Long Island, good luck, right? You make calls, they don't get back to you, your client's upset that this is happening, and you waste a lot of your time getting it stopped. And if you get it stopped, you got it stopped, but your client got no remedy. Our approach is very, very different. So let's take that same scenario. Comes in with a garnishment. You don't have to do anything. You just send it to us. You're done. What we do, we jump right on that. We find out who's garnishing it. We file a motion immediately. We take that filed motion and we email it to the attorney and say, "Hey, you know, you're garnishing this debtor's paycheck post petition with notice. We're filing a motion for willful violation." I guarantee you, I get a call back immediately. That garnishment comes off because now they're back on their heels. Garnishment comes off. They usually say, "Okay, I'm going to cut a check for whatever was taken out post petition. I'll send it to your client." We're not done yet. We still have damages and attorney's fees. So your client gets that garnishment removed immediately, gets the money back that they were was taken illegally post petition, and gets some other additional funds. So when you get these cases that need immediate attention, get it to us immediately and we'll get right on it.